Author Mark Greaney is no stranger to most readers, from his best-selling works to co-authoring Tom Clancy's Jack Ryan novels and, of course, his Gray Man series.
He's given us full focus back to that. The Gray Man is back, and his latest novel will have you on the edge of your seat every step of the way. Mark knows how to do that. It comes out tomorrow, and Mark is back with us today, back home. Yep. Although we know you travel a lot because the research you do is phenomenal.
It's amazing.
Where is
it
this
really is.
Set? Yeah, I mean, you literally embed yourself.
Yeah, I do as much as I can in the time I have. So for this one, I went to Croatia and to Bosnia and to Italy. And then the last act of the book takes place in the West Coast. So I rented a little house in the Hollywood Hills for 10 days just to get the atmosphere of all
get
that.
The feel. Okay,
well, it certainly comes together. And a big part, Mark, of this book also involves human trafficking. Why that issue?
Why that issue? You know, it's a big thriller, action, intrigue, all these exotic locations. And I wanted to look at the largest criminal enterprises in the world because my hero is trying to right wrongs. And human trafficking, sadly, is the third, just behind counterfeiting and drugs.
Wow. So when you were doing that bit of research, I mean, you might have already known that, but did it surprise you that it is so huge?
So much surprised me about it. It was 8 or 9 years ago now, I did a book about the Mexican cartels. Mm-hmm. And I went down to Mexico and did all this research, and I just couldn't believe the scope of things. I mean, we hear about it all the time, but sort of in a remote way.
Right.
And so doing this research, I was, you know, shocked and, you know, really the brutality.
When it comes to the dangers of that also and what you saw in Croatia, how did all that kind of come together? What did you see? What did you...
You know, I don't put myself in danger. I mean, I've had a few weird experiences that, you know, didn't go the way I thought they were going to go. But I'm super careful now to not put myself in too deep because I do a lot of this travel. And I've been in the Middle East and I've been Asia and I've been, you know, Latin America and Central America. And so, you know, I spend a lot of time, like, figuring out who the people are I need to talk to and all that sort of stuff. But there's so much crime, you know, around that, you know, it's hard to avoid, you know, a little bit of danger. When you
right.
Well, we hear Croatia, Bosnia, Italy, human trafficking. Oh, that's over there.
Yeah.
There is tons of it right here in the States.
Which is exactly why I brought it back to the United States. I didn't want this to be, you know, an American hero goes off to some foreign land where...
Right.
Everybody's, you know, bad.
Right.
This ends up, you know, we all seen the Jeffrey Epstein case, and that got a lot bigger as I was, or, you know, like more information came out as I was writing it.
Yeah.
And it just totally dovetailed with the type of story I was telling.
So, Mark, of all of the books, again, we know you really immerse yourself into, again, the research, the writing and all. How did this one challenge you more so than perhaps some of the others?
Honestly, they get harder to do the more you do because you start to write something and you go, wow, that feels a little bit like something I did in my 14th book or something. And so,
what a problem!
Yeah, it does get tougher because I never want to, you know, bring the same story in twice. This one was challenging because of the subject matter. You really have to thread a needle there. You don't want it to be in any way salacious. But it is a thriller. There's, you know, espionage, intrigue, all the tradecraft, the action, and exotic locations. But it's a very tough subject.
We love it when The Gray Man had some romance in the... Which book was it that was
it's
real?
Been a two. It's been two. Two out of nine.
Well, one of them was really... Maybe the first time. Mm-hmm, and I thought, the softer side.
Yeah.
So is there any of the softer side coming out?
There's definitely... This one I wrote in the first person. It's the first Gray Man book I wrote in first person. So you're actually... in his thoughts throughout the whole story.
Was that hard?
It was different, and I just felt like this was the right story to do it, and I think it worked out pretty good, and you do get to see the depth of his emotions throughout the whole story.
Because he's the kind of guy every woman wants to have fall in love with. Really, because, you know, he'd be a tough nut to crack, so to speak.
Yeah, I would think so.
Yeah. From a personal standpoint, though, life is kind of changing for you, isn't it?
It is. I just got engaged. I'm getting married in September. I'm pretty excited here in Memphis and staying in Memphis.
Will that change you at all, especially how you approach some of these different subject matters?
Can I tell you this time next year?
Yes, you can.
I would imagine so in ways that I can't imagine. Yeah.
We got to have you back here to talk.
But we're sure you're already plotting the next Gray Man.
Yeah, book 10 is in the works. Yeah.
Awesome. There's the information right there.
Good
Mark,
to see you again.
Good to have you back. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
You've got to pick up The Gray Man if you do nothing else.
You're right about that.